Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome back to Snack Time. My name is Ben, and in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at a really cool project called Destroyerr. So I wanted to show you the GitHub real quick so that I can kind of like walk you through what I'm seeing and maybe like what I'm thinking it is, and you tell me if I'm wrong. So basically he's saying that it is keeping integrity for mission critical systems. Essentially what it does is you set up a notifier like URL, right? And it checks it every, how often you define. And if a second system hasn't checked in with that notify subscription, then it performs a command and shuts the Docker container down. So if we check this out, let me show you this. So like this one right here, this one is going to check this URL, this Ntfy.sh URL, and I'm going to show you how to create that. I'm going to show you everything. And it checks it every 10 seconds. And if 60 seconds go by and nothing is checked in to this URL here, then what it's going to do is it's going to run this command, which this is just going to run it in the Docker container. So if you do need it to perform something outside of the Docker container, then that's something that we can definitely consider. And there's a whole bunch of one-liners that you can easily run here, and you could pretty much construct the entire command to do almost whatever you want. So they also cover a way for you to set up something on your Android, so something that reaches out to this thing on a certain cadence, like every so often it'll ping the notify site, and that will reset the timer on the Destroyerr, which I think is really cool. So it walks you through how to set that up. It's very easy. It's just a step that runs. So this is the way that I think of it. Say you're running a server. If you have your phone and it hasn't checked in, or you've broken it or something and destroyed it, and that phone does not check in, then the server is going to say, hey, I haven't seen him check in. Go ahead and initiate a complete system wipe, destroy all data, reboot, shut down, pretty much anything that you can really think of. It doesn't have to be that dramatic, but that's where my brain went. So maybe that says something about me. So I'm going to show you how to set this up. It's super easy. There's not a UI to worry about. Nothing really too much, other than we'll cover like some of the stuff that we can do within this command, and I'll show you some really cool resources. Give me just a second and I'll see you back here in like 2, 1 now. All right, so are you ready to install? It's going to be super easy and it's going to be a lot of fun. This is something we're going to set up really quickly. We're not going to be using anything as far as subdomains or Nginx Proxy Manager and everything, because there's really nothing internet facing that we need to worry about. This is all being done from within our network, and it's reaching out to a notification service, which makes it really secure. So let's go ahead and copy our Docker compose file, and let's head over to Portainer. Let's go ahead and add a stack, and let's go ahead and type it in Destroyerr. We kind of covered what this is going to be doing. However, we are going to set up our notify URL. We're going to go ahead and do that before we hit deploy. So let's go ahead and open up our tab that is has notify.sh. So that is the URL you're going to be heading off to. We are going to be using the free version, but they do have pay versions too, and they're very reasonable. They have one for $5 a month, which allows you to have a whole bunch of messages, phone calls, emails, all this other fun stuff, but we really don't need it. They also have an open source version too, so if you wanted to host this service yourself, feel free. Very easy to do. It's just a simple stack that you can deploy, and honestly you can set up yours with usernames and passwords and everything as well, but for us, we're going to keep it simple. We're going to just use what we have out here. So I'm going to go ahead and hit open app. And you see, I already have one set up. I'm going to go ahead and just kind of unsubscribe. So this one kind of took a little bit for me to pick up because I was thinking the whole time, I was like, well, if I'm not signed in and I subscribe to a topic, then anybody will be able to see it. Well, yes, but I'll show you there's a little trick to it. If you hit subscribe to a topic, and this is essentially it should be worded like create a subscription, but we are going to make one here. The pay version, you know, you can sign in with your username and your password. You can have one that is reserved for you and nobody can ever take it and it'll never expire. These right here that we're going to make are going to be a little bit more like random, and they're not going to have any sort of protection on them. So think of this topic name right here. We want to make that something that's a little bit hard to guess. So I'm going to hit generate name. It's going to put a bunch of random characters in here. I'm going to take it a step farther. I'm just going to go ahead and double that up. I'm going to hit subscribe. And now we have created a subscription. If you go to this URL, you will see the exact same thing that I'm seeing. There's no protection here. There's no username and password. It's just out there, but we're not going to be sending it any really secretive data. It's just going to be basically our Android pinging it and saying, keep alive. So the worst someone could do is just also say, keep alive, but they would have to know what the URL is. And that's why we've made it kind of complicated. So I'll show you what that looks like in a second. You can publish notifications, which basically just allows you to do a test if you want. And that's what it looks like. Bing. We'll also I'll show you how to do it through a curl command in Windows. So if you would prefer not to have your phone be the one that's the sending out this information or this little essentially a ping, then you can with like pretty much any operating system, really anything that can reach out to this URL and send a little bit of information is really all you need. But let's go ahead and do this. Let's copy this URL at the top here and let's head back to Portainer. And let's zoom in here. I'm going to paste this URL and I'm going to leave everything. I'm going to take out everything except for the slash SSE. It needs that. I'm going to leave that. I'm going to change my time, my destroy time to 600 seconds, just in case my phone, you know, its battery dies or I'm out without a signal for a little while. Maybe 60 seconds is just a little bit of a short time. Maybe it's not. You know, it's 100% up to you. The command right here, we're just going to leave it as it is. But I want to show you on their GitHub page that you can. You can't obviously shut down a machine that is just, you know, if you initiate the shutdown command, it's only going to shut down in Docker because it's just going to shut the container down. But if you scroll down, they do have some documentation on how to shut down a server from within Docker. So check this out. There's a bunch of really cool things that you can do to update. I guess it's certain files or whatnot, and it'll initiate a shutdown. So I think that's kind of cool. Yeah, like check it out here at the bottom. We have as echo s sysrq sleep 30 echo, and that key right there that you can get from this URL will initiate that shutdown. So I guess it's this one is smb. B immediately reboot the system without syncing the drives. And what's S? S will attempt to sync all mounted systems. Okay, that's kind of cool. So this is a great site to keep in mind. All right, so like I said, we're not going to do anything as far as making this internet facing because there's really nothing for it to be interfacing with. where nobody's reaching out or into our network and talking to the server. This is strictly outgoing traffic. If we go into our Destroyerr, and if you click on the logs button, that's the one right here, we'll see that we have the server is running, and it says no timeout reached, time since last message, 10 seconds, and then 20 seconds. And then 30 seconds, and it'll keep counting up until it reaches the 600 seconds that we specified. Then it will run the command and then it will shut itself down. So let's go ahead and do this. Let me show you what it looks like when we actually do send a message to it. So I have just a regular old Perl command set up here. Let's see here. So here is my terminal window. Let me make it a little bigger. And let's see here. Here we go. This is the one I was using. I'm just going to go ahead and back over this URL. And I'm going to go to notify, copy my URL, and then paste it in here. So it's sending a curl to with the header of title destroyer, and the data is keep alive. So when I send that, you'll hear that little bing. There was me sending it in the background. You can see where Notify just told me that, you know, something was received, and this was the information that was received. And if we go back to Portainer, we'll see down here that a new message was received, and now my timer has reset and is now counting up again until it sees that next curl or a little ping come out of there to that URL. So I like to think of it as a kind of a dead man switch, right? If you were really you were a little sensitive about, you know, the, you know, data on your server or its uptime or something, and you wanted something to happen if you didn't check in, that's a really cool thing to do. And it could also be another server. So let's say another server didn't check in and you want it to perform an action if the server doesn't check in. It could be, you could even do, maybe you could probably even use it as like an uptime timer or something and have it send a notification if your server doesn't check in, something happens and your power goes out or you lost internet. So you don't have to be like super secretive about it, but I am. I think it's cool. All right. So before we really wrap this video up, let's see what kind of commands that we could potentially run from within this destroyer container. So if we click into destroyer here, we can click on this little console command. And I know it doesn't have bash, but it does have sh. So let's go ahead and click on bin sh and hit connect. I don't want my head to be in the way, so I'm going to make myself small. Bloop. And let's just check out the /bin folder and hit ls. So it has a bunch of these commands that we could potentially execute. So that's pretty cool. Let's see. The only thing else that we could really potentially look at is the automate function, really. But I'm going to leave that up to you. It's on the Google Play Store, and it's free to download. It's gotten good reviews, and it pretty much just allows you to automate different processes from within your phone. And if you need guidance on that, there is some instructions here on the GitHub page. All right, so what do you think? Do you think this is something that you would use? What kind of purposes and use cases can you come up for using Destroyerr? I can think of a bunch of them. Most of them are sneaky, but I would love to hear what you guys think and if it's something that you know, you would actually use in your day-to-day lives. All right, well, I appreciate you tuning in, and thank you for spending this brief little bit of time with me. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them down below. Otherwise, I will see you in the next video. Take it easy.